is dream.
Bobby Gentry and Glenn Campbell there with All I Have to Do is Dream. Now here's another track from Billy J. Kramer and the Dakotas, and this is Bad to Me.
If you ever leave me, I'll be sad and blue. Don't you ever leave me, I'm so in love with you.
The birds in the sky would be sad and lonely if they knew that I'd lost my one and only. They'd be sad if you're bad to me. The leaves on the trees would be softly sighing if they heard from the breeze that you left me crying. They'd be sad, don't be bad to me. But I know you won't leave me, 'cause you told me so. And I've no intention of letting you go. Just as long as you let me know, you won't be bad to me. So the birds in the sky won't be sad and lonely, 'cause they know that I've got my one and only. They'll be glad you're not bad to me. Told me so, and I've no intention of letting you go. Just as long as you let me know, you won't be bad to me. So the birds in the sky won't be sad and lonely, 'cause they know that I've got my one and only. They'll be glad you're not bad to me.
Billy J. Kramer and the Dakotas there with Bad to Me. Right, lads, pin your lugs back, and anybody else that's listening. Here is episode 17 of the Glen Midden Chronicles.
After a rather turbulent week with the royal family, the crew of the MV Glen Midden were making their way back to Lewis when an urgent announcement was made on the local radio for the captain to get in touch with his head office. With the use of a mobile phone left behind by HRH, the captain manages to get a signal on O2 and contacts Miss Chance back at headquarters.
Ken, this ratio, you're going to have to do something about you on the radio on the ferry. I can't be dealing with putting all these announcements on the local radio. Costing us a fortune.
Oh, I know. Sandy's been trying, but we keep getting interference and picking up some strange stations on the way. Anyway, what's the matter of urgency?
We've just had a call for the organisers of the MUD. They want to hire the ferry to take the Magdanan Halstead Coolis for Stornoway to the MUD and Falkirk.
You'll be picking up their minister as well for spiritual comfort.
What on earth is the Mahodjadena Halstead or Coolish?
Sack, why are ye bampot? It means the maidens o' Tolsta Coolis.
They couldn't have had an easier choir to pronounce, could they?
I thought you could talk the Gaelic.
Well, I have a few words. Slanger, Camarahu, and Jehacket na Dolive. But just the basics, you understand.
Ah, well, they're expecting you tomorrow, so I'd get a translator if I were you. Bye.
Scotty, Maggie, looks as if we're off on another adventure. We need to get to Stornoway by tomorrow to pick up the Mahujaluin Hostai Hahulish.
I think you'll find that's pronounced Mahujaluin Hostai Hahulish. You see, I have the Barra Gaelic, and that is the finest in the world.
Oh, get a rest, woman. If I hear one more time about Barra Gaelic, I'll no be responsible for my action.
Oh, Scotty, you know that you love the idea of me being bilingual. I can be overcome in two different languages.
Aye, well, you could teach me Gaelic for your Dain Mahidin. I'd be able to use that every time you open your mouth.
I'll tell you what. I'll give you private lessons in your cabin. You'll soon get your tongue around it.
Maggie, you'll have to be the interpreter when we pick this choir up. Scotty, go to the bridge and make sure Thatcher is pointing us in the right direction. Luckily, we still have those containers on board that we use for the royal family to sleep in. They'll do for the choir. Onwards to Stornoway.
With a brisk wind behind them, caused mainly by Maggie's cooking, the ferry docks at Stornoway, and the captain, along with Maggie and Scotty, go on shore to meet up with the choir and the minister.
What on earth is on racket? Is someone dead?
Scotty, that's beautiful. It's a Gaelic song about unrequited love. The man is so sad about his love being taken away from him. Maybe you should learn it in case something ever happens to me and you feel like singing at my wake.
I'll no be singing at your wake, I'll be dancing in your grave. In the name of the wee man, don't dire. Gaze Lena Martell any day of the week.
Would you like me better if I wore a hat like she does?
Aye, one that's got a big heavy veil down the front to block your fazog.
Excuse me. Are you the captain of this vessel?
I am, Captain Horatio MacNelson. Can I help you?
Yes, I'm Reverend Stanley Smallpiece, known to my friends as Stan.
Oh, well, Stan...
But you may call me Reverend. I'll be sailing with you in this fine vessel, along with the choir, to give them some solace and support.
Oh, that's all we need, a whistling vicar.
Reverend, you will be most welcomed on board. Who shall I speak to about getting the choir ready to sail?
That would be the lovely Sister Helen Wheels, from the Order of Perpetual Indulgence.
Helen Wheels?
Yes. She's actually from Castle Bay in Barra, and her name's Constance Sorensen. But after a life of debauchery, fueled by spirits, she found a calling and has been servicing the community ever since. I'll introduce you. Sister Helen! The captain of the ferry would like to speak to you.
Reverend Smallpiece, so nice to see your face so soon. Sorry, I'll be with you 1 second once the choir stops singing.
Is this a wind-up? Does all the population of Stornoway whistle when they talk? It's like being in a cage for your canaries.
There we are. Now what can I do for you?
I simply wanted to introduce you to the captain of the ferry that is taking the choir over to Falkirk. Captain, this is Sister Helen. Sister Helen, this is the captain.
So super to meet you. The singing is sublime, don't you think?
Words fail to express my thoughts on the singing. However, we do need to get you and the choir on board as soon as possible in order to set sail.
No problem. Girls, we need to set sail as soon as possible, so please set about sallying up the gangplank. I do hope there is separate accommodation for my girls. I wouldn't want them rubbing up against your seamen.
Indeed there is. Cabins by royal appointment, no less. Please follow Scotty and he'll show you the way.
With the choir on board, the ferry sets sail for Falkirk. Sister Helen and the Reverend Smallpiece have bunked the girls in the containers that doubled as the royal quarters, even although this meant them sleeping head to toe. It does mean they would certainly be kept apart from the rest of the crew. Meanwhile, on arriving at the Firth of Forth, the purser has a problem.
I am telling you, I am not paying the exorbitant harbour dues they're asking for in that den of iniquity. They would never get away with that in Aberdeen. No. If you want to berth, then you're going to have to find another place.
But that's ridiculous. We need to get into the harbour to let the choir off and get them to the mod.
You're not going to be docking in that harbour. I have the purser's purser, and the purse is tight shut. I have nothing further to add.
I think that means there's no paying out.
Scotty, you always have a knack of stating the obvious, don't you?
I know of somewhere you can berth that's free.
What?
I said, I know of somewhere you can berth that's free.
I know what you said. When I said what, I didn't mean I didn't hear you. I meant what? Or where?
Well, I used to do a run that took me into Falkirk afore the wheel was built. We had to berth somewhere that the customs and excise couldn't see us due to the cargo we were carrying. Anyway, you see, over there.
Where?
There. There where it says, Welcome to Skinflats.
Yes.
Well, we're underground in the mud just outside there, and we can bust the choir to the competition.
Skinflats? I've never heard of it.
Ah, it's a picturesque little village on the banks of the Forth.
Ah, one billiard heed, it's a dump.
What do you know? I've spent many a happy hour in that place.
Aye, I once spent a week there one Friday, you know.
Well, if the purser isn't opening the purse, I don't see we have any alternative. Skinflats it is. Scotty, tell Dick to head us into the mud.
With full steam ahead, Dick manages to get the ferry as far up the mud as possible at Skinflats. The captain sends Scotty and the purser off to hire a bus to take the choir to the competition the next day. But will they manage to get one cheap enough? Will the choir ever sing at the mud? Will they manage to get the ferry out of the mud? Will the Reverend ever stop whistling? Tune in next week, same time, same channel, to find out.
Here we go, Glenn, the Midden Chronicles, episode 17, episode 18, tomorrow. Now, lads, I'll fire those other ones to you, so you can hear them. At least I hope they'll lift, because I can't get them to lift onto here. So, there you go, the Glenn Midden Chronicles. Now, here's Craig Douglas. When my little girl is smiling.
Every time my baby and I have a quarrel, I swear I won't give in. Then my baby starts to smile at me, and I know, I just can't win. When my little girl is smiling, I can't stay mad at her for long. Why should I want to fight when I can hold her tight? I just don't care who's right or wrong. Oh, let me tell you now, when my little girl is smiling, there's nothing more I can say. I see those big bright eyes, and then I realize that girl is gonna get her way. But you would understand why her wish is my command if you were in my. When my little girl is smiling, it's the greatest thrill there can be. She gets her way, it's true, but I know I won't be blue as long as she just smiles for me. As long as she just smiles for me. As long as she just smiles for me.
Craig Douglas, When My Little Girl Is Smiling. Now, here's The Young Idea, with a little help from my friends.
What would you think if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song, and I'll try not to sing out of key. Oh, I get by with a little help from my friends. I get high with a little help from my friends. Gonna try with a little help from my friends. What do I do when my love is away? Is it worrying to feel alone? How do I feel by the end of the day? Are you sad because you're on your own? No, I get by with a little help from my friends. Get high with a little help from my friends. Gonna try with a little help from my friends. Do you need?
need somebody to love.